But the public should be told how I became a legend or who made me into a legend.
Rey López Tijerina, the Alianza, the brown people, the Indo-Hispano. This is the fire that is coming out of the volcano.
He's been blamed for a murder and other acts of violence, praised for instilling a sense of pride in the Hispanic people of northern New Mexico for leading a civil rights movement. Nearly 17 years after the courthouse raid at Tierra Amarilla, some people still hate and fear him, while others revere his name. The reaction was much the same back then.
I would call that man somebody in the category of an enemy of the United States, an enemy of law and order.
I've been telling everyone all along that Reyes López Tijerina professes communism, and the sooner we believe that, the better.
I think he's strong on this, and he's going to fight to the end, even if somebody is trying to kill.
Today, Tijerina blames the news media for the negative picture of him and for distorting his message.
What the news media told him. First, that was a communist. They believed for a time, since they discovered that it was a lie. Well, then they gave it up. Then that I was an Anglo hater. Then they found that it was a lie. They gave it up. Now that I have hanged my gloves and I have given up and I'm a washed out person, already retired, and they're going to find out that that's not true either.
In 1984, you find Tijerina speaks not of land grants, but of old Spanish towns. He says the federal government wiped off the map because of national parks and forests and federally leased grazing lands. Reports in 1977, however, said Tijerina's Alianza movement was to protest the government's violation of Spanish land grants and the June courthouse raid in retaliation for harassment of Alianza members. Looking back...
Happy already. I think my luck and my position is not with that of Reagan, the Nixons, and the Johnsons, and the Senator Montoya's. I think I'm already in the better books, you know.
The 1968 murder of Rio Riba County jailer Eulogio Salazar remains unsolved, and Tijerina still talks scathingly about the people who jailed him and the men who raped his wife and kidnapped his son. It wasn't until this year he allowed his children to attend school, and security at his compound in Coyote remains tight. Religion and law still are major interests.
I want to be remembered as the only man, religious man in the United States, who said, contrary to Billy Graham, contrary to what Herbert Dalby Armstrong speaks every night, contrary to what every preacher speaks in the Sunday, you know, getting money from the public, contrary to them, I want to say that God is going to use Russia to whip and punish the United States.
Some, he says, have told him they'd rather see a Tijerina National Day than one to commemorate the birthday of Martin Luther King. Books have been written about him, documentary films made in this country and abroad, and now the producers of the hit movie Silkwood have set the wheels in motion for a feature film about his life. Tijerina wants Martin Sheen to play the lead. Shane Metzler, Action 7 News.